This is Jeanette. I will show you guys how I do my wash and go. So currently my hair is washed and I already have some Eco Styler in it from a different style. I've already done this part in the back. So basically I just take my hair and I take a spray bottle that has coconut oil and castor oil, and I'm just spraying my hair down. Paying a lot of attention to the roots and my scalp. So the water, I just dropped all my stuff in the sink. Anyway, I'm just gonna push that in and then finger the tangle a little bit and take my fake tangle tweezer. Start from the ends and work my way up my hair. It's like a 4B, 4C mix of patterns in my hair. And it's already detangled from when I washed it earlier. And I have a little Eco in it already. As you can see, it's already kind of good with some Eco Styler. It's combing on through. I already grown so much. Then I take the Eco Styler. I have the yellow one just because I couldn't find the other ones. That's all they have at the store. And I put it on the root and work my way up to. No, I put it on the ends and I work my way up to the roots, which is this part. Okay. And I just put some more and just like flicker the tangle of it through. Trying to not get too much shed in. Because my hair shed a lot. And then I'm trying to like get tangled in different ways so it still has like some body. Because right now, I don't even know, like, if this will last, but I want to be able to put it up and wear it down. And I already have braided this part from my other hairstyle. I'm thinking of just leaving it. Let's see. That would be cute. No, I can always braid it up again. Might as well. While I'm edit. You see, shake it around a little bit. Get it some type of body. I'll wait till it's all done. Okay. I'm just untangling this braid. Scared of heat damage because it's already like loose, especially towards this part, like this one section from when I had like a traditional sewing and this was flour. I think it got heat damage a little, but I don't know. That was like last year or 2 years ago, but ever since then it hasn't been the same. Like my hair used to curl up all the way around. Now, if you look at it, it don't even curl up. It just like waves. Like, it don't even curl. Like, it used to just spring into a curl. I don't know if it's something I got to do for that, but. It's funny because my wig is like the same texture and length as my hair. Only difference is the color. I got a lot of split and dead ends that I need to get cut. And I'm gonna need to get my hair done, so they're not gonna get cut. You see this? It don't even curl. It's like this patch right here that don't even do anything. I don't know what happened. So I'm gonna section this part in two and work some styler at the root and the ends and along the middle. And I just take my fingers and comb it through. Add a little more so I can feel it clumping together. I like to shake it around to make sure it clump good. I must got some type of old product because this part getting white. I hope that's not a leftover shampoo. Because it's not stuff. I didn't put nothing else in my hair. I hope that don't flake. I love this spray bottle because when you press it, it still spray. Like, it spray a lot out at one time. And like, it distributes pretty evenly. I just love this cream on my, this brush on my scalp. When it itch. And when my hair ain't matted, I feel so I could brush this section all day if I didn't care about my hair falling out. Now, I hate that this part is like straight, kind of. Like, it don't even curl. Like, no matter what I do, I don't know what happened here. I don't even know how to fix this. But like, you see it like, it's straight right in this section. And this is probably new growth, but this is probably the heat damage from 2 years ago. Cause even at the ends, you can see like a little bit, like it don't even curl really. It just stick out. I don't know how to fix it. Okay. This will take 90 days for this thing to dry, this hair. I wish it was summertime here so it could dry outside. Close up. I got real bad skin, like it's breaking out, so not real bad, I seen worse, but still. So here with my hair, I don't know, I could be wrong about the curl better. I was told it's 1B, but it ain't no 3 or nothing like that. I think it's a mix of 1B and 1C and 1A. Like all of them. Not 1. 4. Sorry, not 1. No 1. If it was 1, it'd be straight down there. No. 4B, 4A, and 4C. Not 1. Not 1, no. I don't like having a middle part because I have a big head. So. But that's what it's gonna do to this part. This part is gonna look like when it dry, like from a little elongated on this side. I need a cut. You see this section right here? This need to be cut into something, like, cause it's just cut. I would cut it, but I don't want to mess it up more than I have already. So currently this is my hair wet and this is it dry. At least on this side. This side is thicker than this side. This side is easier to manage. But you can see a little bit on this side the damage. I keep dropping my stuff. I have a thing of water right here and a sink just in case I need to, use it. I'll wash my hands off real quick. No, this side. Let me do this right. Because I don't want to lose more hair than I already have. I feel like the amount of hair I shed in the last week from having that sew-in, I had a sew-in, is enough to make 2 full heads of hair for 2 adult women. Like, seriously, it's ridiculous. Ouch. Oof. It's dry and tangled. When I wash it, I didn't use no conditioner because I ain't had none. So I just shampooed it and then put some olive oil on it. And I didn't wash the olive oil out. So my hair is going through some stuff. I probably should try to go get some conditioner for it, but it's too cold outside. This needs to dry inside for the next couple days. I'm gonna be inside. I like to wear my hair when it like dry because it covers my ears under the hat. But it's cold air on my scalp. So I don't get to wash my hair too often in the winter. It's so cold in my house. It's hot out here today, they must have turned the heat up. And I did that. I washed it earlier. I wouldn't even consider I washed because I didn't even condition when I shampooed it earlier. I dry it fast. Okay. My hair literally comes out in globs. But not right now. I think the glob phase is over. Put that in the sink. It's like a big, knot down here. So I like to spray it directly in the knot and squeeze. And then I just help the water penetrate in their tangled section. And spray it in close on myself instead of far away because my hair's so the not nappy, tangled. This from over there. Oof. It's just falling. Okay, this section. So as you can see, the back of my hair is a whole nother texture like than my front. Or maybe I'm tripping. Because the back, like, I have a kitchen that need reconstruction. But then, I have like the hair above the kitchen, like this right here. That's like so, it's so nice. It bounced back, like the curl. And my hair in the world, it's like armpit, mid back, bra strap length. Don't you see in the curl? Probably can't see. This is the favorite section of my head. There's also the section where I lose the most hair. This in the middle and the front is still That's from the Eagle Styler earlier. I didn't have time to do a full wash and go, so I just smacked some gel on it and like didn't even comb it through and just put in a ponytail. That's why it's doing this. See this? This is what I gotta go through. You see that? Tangles like this, I just rip my hair. This make me just want to cut it off sometimes. I don't have the patience to try to go through here and be all nice. But then I want it to be every 5 seconds. Ah, I'm just gonna rip through it because I don't have patience like that for this. For a little eye, Eagle Styler. Under. Alright, I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back. So, that's how the back look. I have like 2 long pieces in the back, that's it. Let's see. This is the 1 long piece of hair I got. That's just there. It's about bra strap on a good day. So let me keep on to the tangle. Ouch. Oh, oh god. You see this? This is a mess. Oh my gosh. I can't even start. What? How did I do that? Ah, now it's stuck. Have mercy. Oh my gosh. The struggle. Oh no, don't tell me it done tied a knot. I lose a lot of hair like this. Oh, look at there. There you are. Oh, so cute. Cute little fella. Or little. My hair can't be fellas. Hey, little. Hey, girl. Putting it at the end. I mean, putting it at the root. And down. The head. And take my detangler. I got this from Medicare in Vietnam. This was the only thing that I could use in my hair there. This, and thank God they sold Eco Styler. And just those two. The only 2 products, and coconut, and all the oils that they got for hella cheap. Coconut oil, jojoba oil, grapeseed oil, all type of oils. They sell that for your hair. That a natural hair can use at Medicare. I was out in Dong Nai, Vietnam, so I got it from the Medicare out there, but they've since closed it. It's probably one of them in Lotte Mart near the Almada intersection. But most of y'all probably in America, so you know what I'm talking about. But in Vietnam, if you're a natural hair girl like me with curly hair, or just somebody who cares about the product to use and want to buy some old good stuff for your hair, specifically curly or damaged, you can find products in Vietnam. Medicare, really good, whatever it's called. Got everything. They got Eco Style. They got oils. They even got Palmer's products at some locations. Like Palmer's, but I don't know. I ain't trust it because I didn't know if it's the same thing. It was the same logo. I should have bought it, but it's a little expensive and I was skeptical. But I know Eco Styling when I see it, so I show thirsty. Excited. It's like a garlic like that. A garlic It's not even real measurements. A dollar per daisy. Put a lot on my room, on the bathroom, and on the end, and down the middle. Then I'm gonna take it in half and rub it in good. The root to end. Please don't knot, don't knot. When I didn't detangle well, oh, I found out the hard way. But I got a hangnail and my finger get caught in my hair. Now this side of my hair seemed longer. Maybe because this side is drying more. Or I really need a cut. But when I was doing this side, it wasn't, I don't know. I need a haircut. Or a trim or something. Probably a haircut. Because trim, I'm probably beyond that point. Who knows? Now here go this. Yeah, it just whoop inside it and come out and whoop go all the way back. Now this shrinkage is real, cause believe me, it grows up even more. Just this one section of my head and my edges, of course. And I come all the way down here and whoop up there. Shrinkage. I like how I wish it could just stay long like this. And not shrink, but that's not how I help. It's magic. Yeah, this side is drying. Let me stop before I get matted. Now, this is what I'm saying when I said, this is where you mess up, where you didn't detangle properly. It don't help that I got a sensitive scalp. And I'm heavy-handed, so it just is. And I'm impatient. So ends of my hair are absolutely horrendous, in my opinion. Y'all, please tell me otherwise. Because if you don't ask me, they don't even curl, they just freeze. That's not curl, but it's freezing. No matter what, I feel like people are never going to be happy with themselves, even if they seem like they got it all good. So let them complain. And people know things will get worse or can be worse, but people will always complain about their situation. No matter how good it seems to other people or how much things could be worse for them. People will always be unsatisfied. That's just how humans are. Unless you're just a grateful person always. Okay, hello. Okay. Oh no, please. I gotta just use clips or something, because this ain't gonna work. Please don't get knotted, don't get tangled. Oh, spoke too. Yep, there we go. I'm gonna let this braid just hang there for a second. You see this? This is what I was talking about. How it just is straight in the middle. It don't even curl. It's just, I don't want to get no more leave out for no sewing again. Unless it's, I'm just gonna rip it. Unless it's curly hair. Don't mind my arm. I had a blister, long story, but it's bruised up. It was black and purple earlier, and it's just red. But no, nobody hit me. Never go to the hospital. Get insurance. As soon as you come back to America, get insurance. There. Now you see this? My camera. I just pulled it. But you can probably still see. It's like two hairs that are knotted, tied a knot in each other. This is the story of my life. You want to make sure when you do wash your rolls or anything when you use in a gel, spritz or anything. I don't know spritz actually. A gel. Okay, I'm going to just speak on what I know. Always make sure your hair is soaking wet. Especially when you use a wet line extreme gel. You don't want to make that mistake, believe me. Your hair just going to be clumped. Make sure you, I'd use a wet line in the shower. Even if I wash out a little bit, you know it's getting on every strand. Because the water is just... I feel like I'm raking the leaves. It's really raking them. Can I get to the scalp and come down? What have I done to you, hair, to deserve this? Everything. It's enough, I have a lot of gel in it already, but this is just so I can do this style. That's it. And I take both my hands and just push my fingers through and act like I'm just like separating. Through. When I act and I am separating through. But whatever you do, make sure if you got nails that you don't need to fill in, believe me, I've lost so much hair from my nail. Like getting caught in a nail, or like, if you go do this, make sure you clip your nails and file the tips, and you ain't got no type of hangnails or nothing, because you will regret. Especially if you got hair like mine, or you doing somebody else's hair, you got curly hair. Why do I do this? I really need to get a clip. Because this is not going to work. I got it. Ow. You could tell the difference between this here and this. When I care and when I don't. I feel so good in my scalp. I need some tea tree oil. To help them out. Damn. Okay. This ends of my hair. These ends feel so dry. The struggle. Yes, I have a lot of hair. Sometimes it seems so thin, and most times it seems so thick. Mostly because it's like matted, because I'm too lazy to comb it. But when I do undo it, can I get to the scalp? Yes, I can. How long have I been here? 30 minutes? Oof. I'm working fast too because I had a head start because it's already detangled with gel in it already. But on a day, if I was trying to do this to go as a wash and go, I ain't gonna know where. It just turned into a wash and sit. Because that's all I'm able to do. Things for no wash and go. That's for people who lucky or they got some hair that don't tangle or they hair real short that don't tangle, because I've been through all those stages. Short hair, Aquablend. Right now I'm at brush shred, 3 years in my natural hair journey. Is it four now or three? I started in college freshman year. So it's been, I do math right now. I'm at the most important part of my hill. It's the thickest part and the most dense. There's nothing like getting a piece of hair with product in your eye. When you got them lashes too. The worst. Because your lash getting away when you're rubbing your eye. Then that getting your eye and the hair product getting your eye. And it's like, Jesus, sorry for ruining the eyeballs you gave me. Because, man, the worst. I take it from both sides at the end. Now you see this. Don't curl for nothing. It's soaking wet. Even when I put the gel in, it's not going to curl. Because this was part of that leave out I told you about from 2 years ago. It's a knot right here. That's right in here. It's not going to curl at all. Nope. What have I done? It's at the end. You can tell the difference. Just like this part. This part together, this part not. This part ready to be cut. Oh, what you doing? Make sure you ain't trying to blend in over there. So, hey, just imagine that, trying to blend in. No. As much as I want to get up, give up, and just leave it, it won't even work out. Make sure that's all I have. Now, it does, can shrink up to this point. And it'll even a little more if I want to do that, but then it's a pain. Even more than this to try to. The tail. I'm so mad. I'm not bad, I'm grateful. I'm not here, but I'm just going to came to see how it goes. Oh, alright, it's nice to be able to do this, but I just wish it dried long. So I can do that. I just wish to drive all the way without me having to put my heater on it. Okay. Yeah, for the scalp. And we have touchdown. All right. So you blend it in. I was thinking about getting some clip-ins, but knowing how my hair tangles when I put eco on it by itself, just imagine trying to blend a clip-in, especially on my root. That thing will pull my whole patch of hair out. Especially the ones that they make nowadays, they're so cheap. I think there's only one type of clip they use to do clip-ins, no matter if it's cheap or not, right? Because I only see one type of clip, unless you like have a new type that them came out with. I can't use no type of clip, no way, no way I wear a wig. If I try to clip a wig in my hair, oh, that hair's missing. It's gonna just be gone. I'm gonna have a patch. It's gonna be broken off. I got parts of my hair that's broken off that I don't wanna get into. Because I was trying to not even think about it. But yeah, even when I wear my wig right there, I gotta put a scarf or some, what's it called? Fishnet? Not fishnet. Oh God, no, not a fishnet. Stocking cap on. Because I made the mistake multiple times of just putting braids in and trying to throw the wig on and just lay it down with baby hairs and eco style. Because I ain't trying to do no actual real. I do it the right way, but I've learned from my mistakes. That's the whole point of making them. Because it's a mistake. You got a miss, now you're going to take it. You take a miss. So, you know, he'll be cute. Oof, I was about to dry brush it. That's cute. That braid out came out nice. Too bad this is not real nice. Oof, I need some clips. I do a lot of wearing them. Make sure you wipe your face down and wash your face after you do your hair. A lot of spray bottles that you put oils in. Because you were wondering why your face are oily after you did your hair. And that's, oh, bad idea. Nice thing about this, the bristles don't break easily, but they do bend. So you can show, oh no. Oh my god, honey. What am I doing? What? Was this part of it? Whatever, bad thing. Oh lord. What did I just do? I hope, you know what, it's like 6 in the morning, I give up, I don't be in the house all day anyway, I just don't want to have to deal with this for whenever I do my hair again. So let me do it right. Oh, hey, that was, and, okay. Let me see. I would suppose this is all part of this. I hate how my hair just comes out. I was going to do the praying hands method, but I think this method is more effective for me. Especially with how I like my definition to be. Because praying hands method, it don't define this good. Not saying this is a good definition, but to me, I'm satisfied with this method. So, oh Lord, it's starting to. Okay. Wow, shrinkage. Boop. That should be a magic trick. Yeah. I put my arm on a wall. Because after I'm done, I'm going to shake it. I want to diffuse it, but people are sleeping. And I'm just taking up the bathroom window. Hopefully no one has used it. I don't know why this is white like this. I really think it's probably... I have a patch of hair with it. Oh, I took my sewing down. Ooh. You heard that? The slap. Hey. Oh. That was funny. What's that? Sorry, I thought that was a part of my mess. I was gonna cry. Last section. We're almost done. Let me get through this section. The front of my hair. Top of my whole head. It's just a lot to me. I so much work. Just imagine when I try to do like half up, half down. A nightmare. I ain't even got that much hair compared to most of these girls on here. I think take care of this. So I'll just rip through it. I'm patient. Hello, non-existent edges. No, yeah, I did a little bit, but it's not like how it used to be. I can't do that multiple direction stuff because things like this happen. So this part will have to just be permanent. I would love to do a little bang look. I have my hair nice this. It don't curl. I can't do no scrunch because it's just gonna do nothing but tangle. But what I do is a whoop. And a whoop. I like how that sound on the wall. That way that all. Owie. I like this one. And if I could do my edges. It looks white, but it's not. Oof, that is. I don't know why I do that. Like product or oil or something. No. Do my non-existent. Oh, hello. Hair. My non-existent edges. Oh, I don't even have an edge brush. So I have to use a tangle. Teaser thing. Let me stop saying tangle teaser. This ain't no tangle teaser. This is not a teaser. A tangle befriender. Because it don't tease nothing. I hate when girls do a little swoop right here. It don't even look natural. Your hair don't even do that normally. So, as you can see, this part is mostly dry, starting to frizz and put a little gel right there. And this part, freshly done. I gotta see how this gonna dry. Cause when I go to sleep, this thing go phew, right here, like this. I'll show you back. This is just this side, I probably need a haircut. I do need a haircut, so yeah, this is my day routine. Ugh, bad idea. When it's dry, I'll come back and show y'all the picture. Good night, or see you later.